This is Russ Anderson. In this tutorial, I'm going to take this shot from Artbeats and track it, solve it, export it to After Effects, and add a simple effect in After Effects. So I'm going to start out by running the auto tracker, not the full auto tracker, but just the 2D part of it, so that I have the tracker locations, but not the 3D solve yet. And I'm going to just go and scrub through. And if you look, there are actually a couple of trackers that are on some cars moving around there. And that's something you always need to take a look out for. It's especially true with these kind of aerial shots that there's almost always something wandering around on the ground. And if SynthEyes just happens to pick it out as a feature, you just want to delete it ahead of time. So now I've run the 3D solve, and now I have all the 3D locations of the trackers, and I also have the camera path, and also the field of view of the camera was just computed as well. So the next thing I'm going to do is a tracker cleanup, where SynthEyes goes and identifies any trackers that have too large of an error comparatively, a large difference between their 2D positions and their 3D positions. These seem to be pretty far off at the distance. They might have jumped around in some of the different features. I don't know. We don't need them. So they're gone. And now we can just rerun that solve. Could use refine mode here if we wanted to speed that up also, if it was a particularly long shot. So now we have our solve. And at this point, I'm going to pick out a coordinate system to make what we're going to do in After Effects easier. And it's always a good idea to try and have a little foresight as to what you're going to do and set up a coordinate system in SynthEyes to make that as easy as possible. So we're going to go to the summary panel and hit this coords button. And I'm going to select a couple of different trackers here. This first one is being set up to be the origin of the coordinate system. This next one is going to be along the x-axis. And this third one is going to be on the ground plane. And SynthEyes goes and applies those particular constraints and spins the scene around in various directions to make that happen. The reason I chose those two as being on the x-axis is that we're going to add some text along that road there. And that will make life easier. So now we've got it lined up. If we export right now, we're going to wind up an awful lot of trackers, layers in After Effects, because each tracker is going to produce a new layer. So I'm going to go to the coordinates panel, and I'm going to tell it not to export everything. And now let's just go back, and I'll just pick out actually the same ones that I just used for the coordinate system setup, and I'll make those exportable. So now we're ready to do the export. So we'll go up here to the After Effects JavaScript export, select our file, and we're running basically the default parameters. There are a bunch of different options here. And you can look through the manual and some of the other tutorials to see what you can do with all these things. One important thing that we're going to do is use this run new project, run now option. And if we go and look at After Effects, I've already started up just so we don't have to wait for it to start. But it's just sitting there doing nothing. And we're going to have SynthEyes automatically start After Effects and run the file that we're just exporting. So you see that happen right now. So that's the time required to export the file, load it up in After Effects, and now we're ready to work. And you see that we've got these different trackers there, and it's actually the full 3D environment. So here are my three different 3D views in After Effects, and you can see the trackers that we exported are there in that environment already. So the one that we're going to be interested in, I think, is actually this tracker 41. So let's go back to just a single view. And we're going to drop in some text. So there's our text. And we're going to first off make it a 3D layer. And now let's just open it up and we're going to start adjusting it a little bit. We're going to take the three coordinate values here, really just the two of them that we need to worry about. We'll make them zero. And now we're going to reparent this. So I'm going to drag from that little funny thing down to tracker 41, and I'm going to hold down Alt as I do that. And that says that we're going to retain that that child transform, which is at 0, 0, 0. So the point of that step of zeroing out the position initially and now reparenting is that that text is now located right at the location of that tracker. So we can start scaling it up to a more interesting and useful size. So we'll make that something like that. And now we can just use the anchor position values to adjust this however we might like. You know, typically for this sort of effect, you have it up in the air a little bit. So now we've got some text hanging up in the air, and of course you've seen this kind of floating text effect in various TV shows and movies and whatnot. So, you know, that's a simple effect. You know, we could do 2D tracking on this, and the key thing here is that we use the whole lineup process and the 3D environment in SynthEyes to be able to align this text exactly with the road, with the features that we tracked in the environment and the vertical direction as well. So because we have a 3D environment and know, you know, where everything is, we can place things into the scene so that they're in exactly the right spots rather than trying to guess and futz things around and animate them over time to make them do the right thing. So hopefully that gives you an example of what this is all about. And this particular example doesn't have any lens distortion in it. There's a little bit of distortion in this shot, but I have some other tutorials that show what happens when you do have lens distortion. You export from SynthEyes to After Effects and show what that looks like in After Effects to how to be able to address that distortion. So I hope you'll check those out also. Thanks.